This is Todd Starnes, and I'll be on your radio at 11 this morning. In the meantime, you're waking up to First News with Kevin Miller on News Radio 102.9 KARN.
And welcome back to First News with Kevin Miller. I'm Toby Howell in for Kevin this morning. I was going to have the whole week off, so he'll go right into the holiday for a 4th of July. Short week for a lot of people out there this week, and so a lot of us will only work the 4 days and then have Friday off to celebrate the 4th of July, which comes up on Saturday. But in the meantime, I do want to welcome the CEO of UAMS, Dr. Steppy Mehta, to the show. And, Doctor, good morning. How are you doing today?
Good morning, Toby. I'm well. How about yourself?
Very good. I appreciate you joining us. And Doctor, I was reading a story last week about the antibody testing that UAMS is working on. And so I was hoping you could explain it a little bit for us and tell us about. So are you working on creating the test, or is this something that you're rolling out to the public at this point?
Yeah, so it's a little bit of both. This is a UAMS-created antibody test that we will be using to do what we call seroprevalence testing throughout the state of Arkansas later this summer and the fall. So it's meant to give a better idea, a better understanding of just how many people have been infected. So as you probably know, antibody testing is really a marker of who has been infected rather than an indication of who currently has the infection. So this will give us a better understanding of how many people across the state, including special populations of individuals, which will allow us to develop policies and better target our testing and hopefully eventually our therapy.
Which one, and maybe they're two totally separate deals, you'll have to explain for me, but which one's more important, the antibody testing or the actual virus test?
Yeah, I'm not sure one is more important than the other, but if you want to know who is infected at this point, there is the virus test, what you alluded to, which is really a polymerized chain reaction test or a PCR test that looks for evidence of virus genes, the RNA, within the individual. So that indicates either active or recent infection compared to the antibody test, which is a marker of an infection in the past. So if we want to make a diagnosis of active infection, the PCR test or the genomic testing is a more important one than the antibody testing.
Now, here's my big question, I've read this, but I don't know if I read it from a good source. So if you take the antibody test and you have the antibody, are you good to go and you won't get the virus again? Like, you know, kind of like what we've had with the chicken pox in the past, or is this not known at this point of if you can get it again?
Yeah, it's not known, unfortunately. The COVID-19 virus is a coronavirus. Many of our common colds are coronaviruses, and we don't develop long-lasting immunity to the common cold, unfortunately. But what we don't know yet is whether we either have a vaccine or get long-term protection from the vaccine, or if we get infected, whether that confers what we call long-term immunity. So we just don't know yet. There is some evidence that if you are infected or if you get antibodies from somebody else, let's say serum from somebody who had the infection, that there is at least some short-term protection.
We're talking with Dr. Steppy Mehta, the CEO of UAMS. And Doctor, is UAMS, are you guys participating or involved in working on the vaccine end of the virus at this point? Do you have research going on at the hospital for that?
Not per se, no.
Okay. Now, I also thought I saw that you're looking to enlist people to participate in the antibody testing, how are you choosing people, and how many people do you need? How's that going to work?
We're going to be testing about 3,000 people per month, the process for identifying individuals is part of a research protocol that is determined by them. By the protocol itself. Mm-hmm. It's of particular interest in populations that are particularly at risk, such as our Marshallese Islanders, as our Latino populations, where having volunteers or notifying individuals that will be looking for volunteers for testing to make sure that we have adequate sampling is particularly important.
Yeah, most definitely. And now, as the CEO at UAMS, you get to deal with the budget and how that flows on top of multiple other things that you deal with. But what's the financial impact been on UAMS from the pandemic, where lots of elective surgeries, the non-emergency procedures were canceled for a long time? How has that affected the hospital?
Pretty dramatically, like just about every other hospital in Arkansas and across the U.S. So we did a voluntary reduction in our non-time-sensitive care, mm-hmm. Would include procedures, et cetera. And at its peak, we were losing about $1 million per day. We are back on track. We're having our hospital is full, and we're starting to see a healthy financial turnaround.
So no questions of financial sustainability with the hospital at this point?
No, not at this point.
Now, we continue to see big numbers of new cases of COVID-19 here in Arkansas. Are these numbers where you thought they would be right now, or is this more or less expected, based on the calendar and the different models that you looked at even, a few months ago?
Yeah, the models that have been out there, which rely on actual information, actual data, continue to show differences. So it's changed over time. So one of the more popular models, the University of Washington model, anticipated actually a lower number than we're starting to see right now. UAMS developed a model as well, and we're tracking pretty well along what we had predicted. And unfortunately, we are going to continue to see larger numbers unless we start to see some real change in behavior, individuals' behavior and mitigation against spread of the virus.
And do you still have the drive-up testing at UAMS right now?
Yes.
And so are you seeing more people coming through that compared to, say, a few weeks ago?
Yes. Our numbers coming through have more than doubled over 3 or 4 weeks ago. We're back to the same kind of numbers that we were seeing at the height of the pandemic in early April.
Now, and as far as the drive-through testing, is that free to the public and you just pull in, wait in line? Is that how it works?
Yes.
Okay.
You don't need to make a reservation. You come pull up. There is a registration that happens when you drive up. There's a phone number to call and to get registered, and then some questions are asked, and then testing is done.
Okay, so very easy to use with the drive-through testing at UAMS. Doctor, I sure appreciate you coming on the show this morning and giving us some news on the antibody testing that you guys are working on and hoping that goes well. But hope you have a good rest of your day and a good start to the week. We appreciate you coming on the show today.
My pleasure, Toby. Thank you. You have a good day as well.
Thank you. There is the CEO of UAMS, Dr. Steppy Mehta.